supposed to say something, Prabhu. Yeah, so the level of consciousness for the so some might say, okay, even plants have life, why don't you so you are killing a plant too, but then so you don't see the kind of blood or anything when you eat a plant, but then in animal the blood, all everything comes out, and from that we can know that the kind of pain that the animals suffer because they have a higher level of consciousness than the plants.
Yeah, very good point. Very good point. Yeah, the animal consciousness is much higher, almost closer to a human than a plant consciousness. And in many cases, when a plant, you take an apple from an apple tree, you are not killing the tree, right? When you take grapes from a grape bush, the grape bush lasts for many years. You don't like remove the bush every year. So you're not killing that living entity. You're only taking the produce, right?
So, yeah, so somewhere it was compared between a slaughterhouse and then a field where paddy is harvested. So when the paddy is harvested, to a person who's interested in analyzing these two things, when you do a paddy harvest, you feel happy because the paddy is harvested, the plants are all, so everything is done because you had a good harvest. But then simultaneously with the salt slaughterhouse, you see the kind of pain and the kind of emotions that the animals are displaying.
Correct, correct, yeah. So not only from our health perspective, obviously, because our digestive tract is long, we need to only eat fruits and vegetables and grains. And of course, milk is allowed. But also the pain that the animals go through, you actually see it. When paddy is harvested, you don't see pain. But when animals are slaughtered, you actually see the pain. Anybody has any other thoughts?
So one more point, Prabhu. Also, the even for the hardcore non-vegetarians, so the doctors here prescribe to eat white meat rather than red meat. So
yeah, but meat is meat.
Meat is meat. Yeah. But what I'm saying is, even they say red meat is not good, which means meat in general is not good. But then when they compare the white meat with the red meat, the cow, it all comes under red meat. So which is even more dangerous. It's not that to support eating white meat, but then I'm just saying.
Yeah, that is a good point. Yeah. And in general, the pain caused to birds is lesser than that caused to a cow. So, I mean, definitely eating beef is the worst thing. Ideally, they should not eat any meat. But if they cannot control themselves, white meat is better than red meat. And I also posted on YouTube last week around why you should not eat fish, because fish are water filters. Okay. Anything to add, Naga Prabhu? Or Karthik?
So in this slide, you're talking even about like the, you're talking mainly about eating cows, Prabhuji. But in other countries, they also eat like worms and other.
Yeah, everything. When the human being has a long intestine, they cannot digest any of these things. That will cause putrefaction, means this food starts decaying and causes colon cancer. That's why America has the highest colon cancer in the world, because they eat the highest amount of animal flesh in this country. So that's what it is.
And this is one common thing which even the impersonalists accept, at least most of the impersonalists accept.
Yeah, almost all, anybody who has some sense will accept. Right? Actually, even meat eaters to a certain degree accept, but they cannot control themselves because they don't have higher knowledge.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna, Naga Prabhu. Yeah, any thoughts on this one?
They all are very valid and noticeable points, Prabhu. But when Sarna Prabhu mentioned he specified about the tooth, right? The two sharp tooth. So that remembered one of my conversation that I had with my school friends. So they used to justify that even humans have that two sharp teeth, so humans were allowed to eat the meat. So anyway, we are not into that, but even humans has the two sharp tooth. So that reminded me.
Yeah, so I agree with that, Prabhu. So I saw this video in YouTube wherein a person who's very sensible and he makes this comparison. So yeah, even human has this small projected teeth. But then if you see the wild animals or any kind of animals which has this teeth, the strength of those teeth they are really strong. So those two teeth, which is used to tear the flesh from the animals when they hunt it. That is not the case with human teeth. I can send you that video wherein he not to do anything with the religious thing, but then he sensibly compares eating plants and eating animals and how he actually easily overcomes those people who compares this valid idea of, okay, you are also killing a plant. So those kinds of irrelevant arguments, he actually suppresses all those arguments. I can forward that video in our group.
Yes.
Yeah, sure, Prabhu. That'll be good to...
So there are a lot of foolish arguments that people make, but the end result is these are very sentient and intelligent animals, these cows. And, they also have emotions, they form friendships, they remember everything. When their babies are taken away, they cry a lot, but they are also affectionate and forgiving. And in normal sense, if they are not killed, they live up to 20 years. So these are very, very sensible creatures. So people who make those false arguments are not being logical. That's all I can say.